that root in both the equations, you will get these two equations. Now from here, you will try to get alpha. You will always find alpha only. And what you will do for that, you will use the elimination process. What you are going to eliminate? You are going to eliminate alpha square. So just like the elimination by equating the coefficient. Elimination by equating the coefficient that you used to do in linear equation to variable. Similarly, what I am doing, so I am eliminating alpha square. Elimination by equating the coefficient. So how to equate? We multiply first equation, that is this one, by A2, and second equation, that is this one, by A1. That I have already done here. Okay, and I will do the same thing again and again in the question. So when you will multiply these two equations by the corresponding coefficient. Corresponding coefficient means first equation will be multiplied by coefficient of alpha square from the second equation. Okay. And in second equation, the whole equation will be multiplied by coefficient of alpha square from the first equation. That means you have to multiply by the other coefficient. Just like A2 and A1. What will happen as a result? When you will multiply and simplify these equations, simplify means subtract. Okay. This term will get cancelled. This is what I'm saying, elimination. And what will be remaining as a result? B1 A2 alpha minus B2 A1 alpha and A2 C1 minus C2 A1. Okay. Please keep yourself muted. Be careful
what
when
is
you are attending the class.
So what is
One by one. Yes.
So what is the X that is over there, which you have underlined? What does it represent?
No, this is not X. I was saying this is multiplication. Please pay attention. Listen carefully. It is not possible to repeat everything every time. So pay attention. I was saying that this is not X. This is for multiplication. So what is the meaning? I am multiplying this whole equation by A2. This is what is the meaning of this symbol. Okay. And regarding this equation, yes, I am multiplying both sides by A1. This is what I am saying. Okay. You can also observe the steps also. So once we get these two equations, we will subtract them because in this way, alpha square will be eliminated and only alpha will be remaining. What is this value? This is the value of the common root. Okay, this is the value of the common root alpha. Once you get alpha, you can easily get other roots also. That is beta and gamma. Please mute yourself. I can hear some voices from the background. Please keep yourself muted. Adonis, I think it's from your side. Okay, so this is the value of alpha. Okay, and once we have the common root, we can find the other roots also. Like if you have the value of alpha, you can find the value of beta how? Because product of roots, alpha into beta is C1 by A1. Similarly, you can find gamma because alpha into gamma will be C2 by A2. This we have already discussed in previous classes. Let us try to solve a question based on this article so that we can understand these steps and what is the meaning of getting the value of alpha and how it will be useful in finding other values. Let us have a question first, okay? Just a minute.
Please scroll up for a second.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so let us take some example now. Okay. Okay, so the question is, find the value of k so that the equations 2x square plus kx minus 5 equals 0 and x square minus 3x minus 4 equals 0 may have one common root. This is the question. So as I was saying, in the question itself, it will be given that there are two quadratic equations and they are having a common root. So based on this, they can ask you to find some values or something. Okay. Listen very carefully and let us use the same working rule. Okay. The same working rule that I explained once again. So this first quadratic equation, let's say the roots are alpha and beta. Okay. And the next quadratic equation, it will definitely will have one root common because it is given in the question. So let us say alpha is the common root. If you want, you can say beta is the common root, but only one. Either alpha will be same or beta will be same. So let's say the roots of the second equation are alpha and gamma. Now use the same procedure that I just explained. Okay. Therefore, 2 alpha square plus k alpha minus 5 is equal to 0. Why? Because alpha is the root of first equation. Again, alpha square minus 3 alpha minus 4 is equal to 0. Why? Because alpha is also the root of the second equation. Now, what I said after this? I said that we have to eliminate alpha square. So, what I will do? I will multiply this equation by the coefficient of alpha square of the other equation. And what is the coefficient of alpha square in the second equation? It is 1. So I can say that I am multiplying. What is the meaning of this? This means that I am multiplying the whole equation by 1. So basically it will remain same, but still, since it is the method, that is why. And second equation, this will be multiplied both sides by the coefficient of alpha square of the first equation. So we basically interchange the coefficients and multiply. What will happen as a result? First equation will be this only. Second equation, this will be 2 alpha square minus 6 alpha minus 8 equals 0. And I asked you to subtract the two equations because we are eliminating alpha square. So I am subtracting here. As a result, this will be cancelled. Now we will have k alpha plus 6 alpha. 8 minus 5 is 3. Okay. Here I can take alpha common. As a result, alpha is minus